Hi, Chuck Huber here for the Stata YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you another new feature in Stata 16, item response theory models for multiple groups. IRT models for multiple groups allow you to fit a variety of models such as 1PL, 2PL, and 3PL models, graded response models, rating scale models, partial credit models, and nominal response models, and you can fit all of these models by group, either constraining the parameters to be equal or allowing the parameters to vary across groups. You can also test for differential item functioning and compare the results using tables or graphs. Let's look at a quick example using the MASC2 dataset. You can open this dataset by typing web use MASC2. And this dataset contains 9 questions, and notice that there's another variable called female here, so each of the questions are answered by both males as well as females. We can fit an item response theory model by going to statistics and selecting item response theory, IRT, and this opens the IRT control panel. So I'm going to begin by fitting my model, and I'm going to fit a 2-parameter logistic model or 2PL model. And here, towards the bottom of the screen, I can select the questions. So I'm going to select questions 1 through 9. And then just below the items box, there's a box labeled group variable. So I'm going to select female for my grouping variable. And then I'm going to click fit model, and this will fit the model. So if I scroll back up, I can see that the dialog box issued the command IRT followed by 2PL because this is a 2PL model. And I also see a list of my items, and then what allows us to fit this by group is the option comma group followed by the grouping variable female. And if I scroll down, I can see one set of output. Let me scroll down a little further. One set of coefficients for the males and another set of coefficients for the females. I'm going to save this for later use by typing estimates store no diff, and I'll come back and use that later on. Let me show you a way that you can view the parameters in a little more compact fashion. So I'm going to go back to IRT, and then I'm going to click on report, and then I want to select under common reports, I want to select report estimated group IRT parameters and click submit. If I go back to the results window and scroll up, I can see that the command here is estatgreport. And what this does is it shows me my discrimination and difficulty parameters in 2 columns, one for males and one for females. If I had a 3rd and 4th group, they would continue in columns over here off to the right. Now, notice that the parameters are all the same for both males and females, and this is the default behavior. By default, all of the parameters will be constrained across the 2 groups, other than the mean and variance of theta here at the bottom. So that's how we can fit the model constraining the parameters. Let's see how we can do this and unconstrain the parameters. If I go back to statistics and IRT, I want to go back to my model tab, and I want to fit a hybrid model this time. And next to hybrid model, I'm going to click create, and I'm going to begin by creating a submodel. So again, I want a 2-parameter logistic model, and I'm going to begin by selecting questions 1, 2, and 3, and then 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So I want all of those to be the same, so that's going to be my first submodel. So now I'm going to fit another submodel by clicking Create. And again, I want to select a 2-parameter logistic model. And this time I'm going to select group variable, and for female 0, that indicates that these would be the males, I want to fit a submodel for question 4 for the males and click OK. And then I want to create another submodel, which is also a 2-parameter logistic model. And this time I'm going to select 1 for the females and select question 4. And now I'm going to click OK. And Stata will fit this full model, including these 3 submodels, when I click OK and fit the model. And just so I can see the results a little more clearly, I'm going to click report again and report the estimated group IRT parameters. And when I click this and go back to my results window, if I scroll back up, I see estatgreport again. And as I scroll down, the parameters are constrained to be the same for question 1, question 2, question 3, question 5. But if I scroll down to the bottom, I see that for question 4, the parameters are not constrained to be the same for both males and females. And I'm going to quickly type estimates store diff Q4. And now I can do a likelihood ratio test to test for differential item functioning. So I'm going to type LR test, no diff, and then diff Q4. And this indicates the likely 2 degree of freedom likelihood ratio chi-square of 12 with a very small p-value suggests that I do have differential item functioning for question 4. And I can view the graph of that by going to statistics, going back to item response theory. If I go to graph, I can view the item characteristic curve for question 4. When I click submit, notice that I have two curves. The blue curve is for the males. These are both for question 4. The blue curve is for the male, the red males. The red curve is for the females. So again, the LR, the likelihood ratio test tests whether or not we have differential item functioning in this item characteristic curve, kind of confirms that visually for us. So these are some of the things you can do with multigroup IRT in Stata 16. If you'd like to learn more about this feature, you can visit our website. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.